Finally, the day has come. Everybody's been waiting for it very much. And this is the biggest video to date on my channel about the GR Yaris engine preparation. You will find nowhere else the objectified data that we have pulled together here. All the data you see is regards of the engine on the same bench dyno, various cars, various tests, but always objectivized in the exact same manner. Today you will understand which cams to use from Kelford, which not, and you will understand what effect the single modification do, including various turbos. So let's get into it.
Hi guys, so we are now finally in the GR Yaris with the cams mounted, and here with me is Matteo Dasso, the owner of ACME Motorsport, that very kindly has done all the work on the car. So first drive, first impressions, and we're gonna get them live with you, because I literally just drove out of the place and I've got my oil at 60 degrees and heating up. So let's see how the car goes. Also the tires and everything and brakes are still cold because the car hasn't been moving for over a week now. So of course we need to be ready. We're heading up to a little street that should be a bit more drivable. And anyways, I can say that we also have the Syvecs TCU controller, so this will be a good opportunity to test and see how this works for us. Track, okay?
Yes, is now this set with the rally specs that we use on the R1T Yaris car.
Super. So now we've got the rally software in it, but later he's also going to show me how myself and any user that buys this TCU controller can change their own settings to their liking, both for the accelerating part of the work of the differential and the decelerating part. And settings also include, for example, taking account of the steering wheel angle sensor from the steering rack, so it's quite complete. You know that there was a phase in the WRC in the late 90s and 2000s when the pilots were not changing the settings on the dampers anymore, but they were changing the settings on the central differential. This is how much difference it makes. So now we will see. Matteo, always straight, yes?
Yes.
Fantastic.
500 meters and we will turn left.
Okay, we're almost there. So I can say that the car feels very immediate. It feels more ready than before, and I think also the transmission. When I lift off like this in the curve, I feel just slightly. It has to be it has to be posed in one side or the other. Yeah, you can feel that it detaches a bit quicker. Okay, so now let's go and see this this road and let's see how the car works for real. Okay, maybe we have to let the motorbike by, yeah? Feels good. It feels good. So here we're talking of about 40 horsepower more than what we had before. and you feel the car pushing very strongly. I feel the tires are still a bit cold. I can't really feel so much the difference in the differential yet. Okay, yeah. So I'll catch up from you now from the next stage, and I will talk to you in detail because I want to focus on driving a bit faster and seeing how it actually reacts. Cheers. So that was so fun because I was driving the car and saying, yeah, it goes a bit better, but you know, not so much better. And Matteo was asking himself, what may be wrong? What may be wrong with this? And nothing was wrong because we were in the multi-map mode in the first map that was not delivering power. So we were, in fact, more or less at the same power as I brought the car here. Guys, with the big map, it's a completely different thing. So there is a great, great difference in power, and especially in delivery. Maybe you can think that 40 horsepower are not so much, but you know, 40 horsepower are the difference from, let's say, even more than the difference you have from a stage one GR Yaris and a stock one. And this is another difference of this kind on top of it. So it does make a huge difference. So now Matteo is going to show me how to map with the Syvecs TCU controller. That's going to be interesting. Works really well. So this is to show you how a Syvecs TCU controller works. So basically here you have on this axis the speed, and on the X you have basically the duty cycle of the engine or the accelerator and the load. And in the middle, these are rescaled, obviously, they're not one-to-one numbers. You see what you want to have the central clutch doing when you engage and when you disengage, because basically, automatically, if you pull your foot up partially or totally, you are disengaging. So it's like two ramps in one. So in this way, you can control how the car is working for this. And I must say, I just tried it. Also, Matteo's here. And we're sitting in the rear of the Yaris doing this because you can connect with your USB cable and it's very simple.
Very romantic.
And romantic if you're sitting in two of us in the back. And yeah, it does work actually really, really good. So I'm super happy of the additions we have here, and the power is solid. And let's see some numbers. Thank you very much. So now finally to what all of you want to know. How much power did this make? This made 345-ish horsepower after we downscaled it from 360. So it was at 360, but we saw that there was a possibility that it would pull back a bit in altitude and under heavy driving. And the guys know me, so they wanted to make a map that would work constantly at the same power in any condition. Okay, so now let's get into what you're actually really wanting to see, the curves. So here we have a comparison. First of all, the start is my own car as it drove in. So this is a full bolt-on car with intercooler and intake of ours, and 70 millimeter full exhaust with DCAT. So I had just a standard map coming out from, let's say, a 95 octane fuel standard map, and it made 307 horsepower and 453 newton meters. So you see that as soon as the torque came up, it immediately hit the torque limiter in the map, and therefore this big dip that is going down. And then the power's coming
all the way up and still has a big dip around 6,300 RPM and then trying to push over, but not much left there. So the calibration 3-4 is the calibration we set back to once we understood that around 360 horsepower, we were not sure we could guarantee the power in high altitude conditions and in extreme heat and use. So this is the final, let's say, bulletproof mapping, where we get to 344.5 plus or minus 5%. Of course, this is a hub dyno, very precise, but this is what it is. And about 490 newton meters of torque. You can see in this case, you can compare directly the three curves, and you can see that also with the cams, we are spooling sooner because we managed to have a better engine flush, and we managed to come up, and you really do feel it with all the ignition advance that you managed to do with the EcuTek map and the better management. You get a very, very clean curve in comparison. So what is more interesting is to see how this compares to a car that has got no cams, full bolt-ons, and a Syvecs. So in this case, you see that the green line with no cams at all is very, very strong. And I mean really strong. So this is where it gets to. And you see therefore that the EZ cams, the EZ profile cams from Kelford cams are doing something, of course, they're more powerful, but it's only a 6 degree increase, rotational degree of the timing of the cams, and just a few millimeters of lift more. So it's not like it's changing your world here. In fact, I'm gonna show you now what happens if you install some A cams. So here we are with a comparison of my car with the final map, Easy cams and EcuTek, and a car with the Syvecs and A profile cams, always from Kelford. And a small disclaimer, as you see, the rose line, that is the other car, basically is starting and ending before. So this is just because the dyno that day, the same dyno, was loading up a bit more, and it made the car spool a bit before. So in reality, the A cams are spooling because we have seen a lot of graphs, we've been through a lot of graphs today, they're spooling up around 400 RPM later than the EZ cams. So this said, you see what a huge difference there is, always on the stock turbo, from around 4,500 revs all the way to red line. And this is because the longer camshaft timing on the Syvecs A cams helps the engine to evacuate all the exhaust gases, and it helps the turbine in spinning and going forward. I mean, we, yes, could do a bit more power, but then the car would be on the limit of pulling back on the EZ cams. So we could have got almost where we were, but you have to consider that the other car is safe also where it's running. Therefore, in fact, the A cams make you lose very little at the low RPM range, but give you very much in change up above. So let's see now what happens if you put a TTA turbo or a G25 550. So there are a lot of lines here, but you can see that the TTE turbo, yes, does pull later, but wow, look at that power. It really makes a huge, huge difference. So you see that in regards to my turbine, it is making the power and it's making it at the same time, but just keeping it up all the way. And this is with the A profile cams, and it's keeping a very, very strong power all the way. And also the G25 550 just continues making power, but I think that it's paying a much, much bigger price because it's pulling, let's say, it's on full boost at almost 4,500 RPM. So that's very, very different. So you see, in the end, in my advice, the good sweet spot is always being with the A-cams. Although, I mean, somebody had to do the testing, right? I did it for you guys. And if you want something more, going with a TTE or a GCG or another reliable hybrid turbo. This is the maximum sweet spot, because after that, you're really messing up with what this car is doing. And if it has to be a daily or a track day car, I'm not so sure. Obviously, if that becomes a race car or some car that you just jack up and use only at the racetrack, well, in that case, I would just go crazy and maybe make 600 horsepower. But in that case, you don't have to drive it home and there's no problem, anything happens. So this is, I believe, very precious material, and I really hope you enjoy it and it can be of help for your decisions. And stay tuned to the channel. Please support, subscribe, and let me know what you think about this. Open to reply. Bye-bye now.